Rex and Prano in the building. Yeah. Squish is back. For the sequel. Yeah, we signed on a new live station. What can I do with the black and white? Forget all that. Now, I had a plan to review something else, but something else came up that I bought, and it's like, I wasn't going to review it at first, but you know, man, I keep y'all with the latest y'all know about, so it would be unfair for me not to throw this your way. So, I got it. I got Kamen Rider Climax Hero for the PS2 over it. Yeah, I said it, Kamen Rider. Not that Dragon Knight nonsense that comes on KCW or whatever the hell they call that channel that I don't watch no more. This is based off the Japanese version. The actual good version of the damn series because it's the original. Now, I'll be honest real quick. Another Rex and Prano history lesson. I just recently really hard started getting into Kamen Rider and watching a lot of the old Heisei episodes and things of that nature. Decatur the crack. You know what I'm saying? Ooh, excuse me. I didn't have some drink. You know what I'm saying? Decatur is the crack, and I love it. You know what I'm saying? It's almost over, and Kamen Rider double will be on in a minute. So, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, and this was a last minute decision to pick it up, but I went on ahead and bought it, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, hey, if I need to wave $8 on something, I'll find something to wave $8 on, man, get to it. Now, I won't say this was a waste because the game is good, a tad rushed for whatever reason, but the goodness does shine through. What I will tell you so you can buckle in, this will be a two-part review because of all the crap I have to explain. And it's gonna take a lot more than 10 minutes for me to explain it all. So, if y'all ready, I'm ready, Squishy's ready, and I'm about to do something I ain't done in a while. We about to bring it back. Shaky Cam is back, y'all. Shaky Cam is back. But I ain't gonna talk no more, man. Let's go ahead and get into it. Alright, Squishy.
Go sit down, boy. Good boy. Good boy, Squishy. Good boy. Let me adjust my camera here. Boom, just a little bit. Okay, I think that's cool. I like that. Now, welcome to Kamen Rider Climax Hero. All I'm gonna do in this part is just, you know, is to try to get in as much as I can in the time frame I can. The second part more likely to be about battle system and characters. So, we gonna start with where we are now. This is the cave mode. Everything that's unlockable in this game is unlockable one way or another through either decay mode or putting in a password. I'll be honest, I beat decay mode with all S's every stage and didn't unlock dark decay, and I copped out and put the code in because no one on the internet knows how to unlock them yet, so I'm like, screw it. I might start over just for the hell of it, you know what I'm saying, because the game was that fun to play. But pretty much, decay mode breaks down like this. You have missions, and then you just whoop people's ass, and then you get crap for whooping people's ass. It's real simple. It's nice reward. You whoop ass, you get stuff. Now, there are a couple of things that are weird about decay mode. There are characters that are exclusive that you can only see or only play as in decay mode. That being G3X from Agito, that being Gatak, and that being Auto-Vigen from 5. I don't understand why that you would make characters playable exclusive in one mode, but you can't control them in a versus battle. Makes no sense. That is one of the things that showed that this game was rushed to come out with that Die Shocker movie. Now, I'm like this. This could have been, for real, some Mortal Kombat trilogy type nonsense, where every character, all in the building, all of them. That would probably happen probably when Kamen Rider games start hitting 360 or PS3 or something like that. It would even be good to see it on the PSP. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, everything that's unlockable, the four unlockable characters, Ikuza, DN, who I love, dog. I feel like DN is that cat, dog. Dude is a beast. DN, Zeranos, and Dr. Kane are the four characters that you unlock through the K mode. You see characters like Negadeno, and Ryuga that you fight on level 3 decay mode, but you can't play ever. I'm sitting back waiting for the Game Shark cheat, the action replay, whatever the hell you use to unlock all these characters, kind of like Gun and Battle Assault 2, you know what I'm saying, because that has something similar. But you know, that's pretty much it. I'm gonna explain a little bit more about the K-mode as I go down the list, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep it moving. This is battle mode. Now, to be honest, I had an issue with battle mode, and here it is. That, by default, if you don't have a second controller in your PS2, it defaults to, like, a versus mode, and I was sitting around here for like an hour trying to figure out what the hell was going on. When I finally plugged in the PS2 controller, as you see me hit circle, it gives you an option to fight either the computer or to fight someone else around you or whatever. Let me zoom back out because it's doing that flickering nonsense. Okay. But yeah, but it's just pretty much a standard battle mode, nothing too serious or anything like that. Survival mode. Now, I played this one time with Decade and got whooped like after three fights, because that's like when I was first like looking at the game before, you know, I learned about the combo system and things of that nature. But I don't think it's just a survival mode just for fun. I don't think you get anything special from it. And if you do, I don't know about it yet. This is practice mode. You know what I'm saying? It's a good practice mode, you know what I'm saying? Infinite energy by, infinite super meter by default. Practice your combos in it, blah, 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 blah. You've seen one practice mode, you've seen them all. It really honestly seems like I use that line a lot. Like, all the time. But you know it is what it is. This is gallery mode. Now, what happens in decay mode is every time you win, you unlock either a final a final ride for decay, a final form ride, that's level 2, and level 1 for final or for form ride. Okay, let me bring that back real quick. In level 1 decay mode, you unlock final or form rides for decay to use in battle, and level 2 you unlock final form rides that he can use as his special move and as his counter move and battle mode. And level 3 are just like fun fights that you don't get anything, but you unlock, I think you unlock Akuza from level 3, because I played this game last night and got on Turtles afterwards and forgot what the hell was going on. But yeah, you unlock cards, that's what I was getting to, and what you also unlock, pictures from the TV, from the cage, so you know what I'm saying? It's that picture, that one fine chick. Yeah, I looked at that for a minute. But yeah, it's really fully featured. You also unlock cards that represent the different worlds that the K travels to and the different eras of the different show from the Heisei era as well. So you know what I'm saying? If you actually know some Japanese and you're not really familiar with Kamen Rider, you can get your history lesson game up. You know what I'm saying? And Optimo, you know what I'm saying? You've seen one of them, you've seen them all. What I will suggest is, and I'll tell you this, you know what I'm saying? I know I said this once before. In my, what review was that I said that in? My Kenichi review, and I'm going to say it here again. Turn on autosave! For Jesus Lord's sake, turn on autosave! Because you do not want to play this game and not have autosave on, because the game does not autosave for you. You'd have to come back. If you do something in decay mode and you want to save it, you have to come back to the main menu. Autosave kills all that, you know what I'm saying? And it does a real good job of autosaving whenever you need it to. Now, I'm just gonna go ahead and give it a score, you know what I'm saying, before I get into the character overview, which will probably be part 2. The game for me, I like it. The game gets a 7 out of 10 for me. Here's why. The game looks good, the game sounds good. You have characters that are unfinished because you're trying to cash in on a movie. This doesn't affect me at all, but this game could have been a lot better than what was presented. I'm serious. I'm serious as I say this. The game could have been a lot better than what it presented. And because of the story of Kamen Rider Decay, this game could have been beastly. But pretty much all I've heard in my research of this game is how the Kabuto game is like the bee's knees. So I might have to go find that on eBay and buy it. And if I like it, I'll review it. And if I don't, I'll review it, because you know me. But yeah, pretty much like I say, Gang gets a 7 out of 10 for me. If you're a fan of like Super Sentai, Tokatsu, things of that nature, you'll really like this game. You know what I'm saying? But you might want to, you know, just look at a couple YouTube videos, check it out for yourself, see if you like it before you spend $70-$80 like I did getting it. And that's including shipping. But that's it for me right now. I'm probably gonna put up part two later, and I'ma cover all the characters and things of that nature. But I'll be back in a minute, man. I appreciate y'all watching. Squishy says thank you, and we'll be back in a minute, man. You know what it is, your boy Triple, man. How